Namaskar, good evening. You are watching Rajya Sabha Television. I am Smriti Rastogi with news tonight. Let's begin the bulletin with the top headlines. Motion of thanks to the President's address passed in the Lok Sabha. In his reply to the debate on the motion, Prime Minister Modi asserts that his government will work to fulfill the dream of a vibrant, inclusive and prosperous India. Assures government's fight against corruption will not be driven by vendetta. Prime Minister Narendra Modi calls anti-triple talaq bill a chance for Congress to correct its mistakes on failure to support rights of Muslim women. Recollects that emergency imposed by Indira Gandhi on 25th June 1975 had made the entire country a prison. In the Rajya Sabha, MPs of various parties take part in the debate on the motion of thanks to the President's address. Upper House adjourned for 3 hours as mark of respect for departed BJP member Madan Lal Saini. Nomination process ends for by-polls to 6 Rajya Sabha seats. External Affairs Minister S. Jay Shankar and Jugalji Thakur file papers from Gujarat. The Election Commission announces biennial election on 18th July for 6 vacancies in Rajya Sabha. And Kerala tops state health rankings for the second year in a row. Andhra Pradesh and Maharashtra come next. Uttar Pradesh and Bihar remain at the bottom in Niti Aayog's Healthy States survey. Replying to the debate on motion of thanks in Lok Sabha on Tuesday on the President's address, Prime Minister Narendra Modi said that the government and the opposition have to work together to fulfill the dream of a strong, safe, developed and inclusive nation.
कई दशकों के बाद देश ने एक मजबूत जनादेश दिया है. एक सरकार को दोबारा फिर से लाए हैं, पहले से अधिक शक्ति देकर के लाए हैं. आज के सामान्य वातावरण में भारत जैसी वाइब्रेंट डेमोक्रेसी में हर भारतीय के लिए गौरव करने का विषय है कि हमारा मतदाता कितना जागरूक है. वो अपने से ज्यादा अपने देश को कितना प्यार करता है, अपने से ज्यादा अपने देश के लिए किस प्रकार से वो निर्णय करता है, इस चुनाव में साफ साफ नजर आया है.
The Prime Minister reiterated that after many years, the people of the country gave a strong mandate and re-elected the NDA government. He said that the Lok Sabha elections have shown that the people are thinking about the betterment of the country over themselves, and that spirit is commendable.
ये 5 साल के अखंड एक निष्ठ अविरत तपस्या का जब फल मिलता है तो उसका संतोष एक आध्यात्म की अनुभूति कराता है. और इसलिए कौन हारा कौन जीता इस दायरे में इस चुनाव को देखना मेरे सोच का हिस्सा नहीं हो सकता है. मैं इससे कुछ आगे सोचता हूं और इसलिए मुझे 130 करोड़ देशवासियों के उनके सपने उनकी आशा आकांक्षा ये मेरे नजर में रहती है. माननीय अध्यक्ष जी, 2014 में जब देश की जनता ने अवसर दिया और सहज भाव से मैंने कहा था कि मेरी सरकार गरीबों को समर्पित है, आज उस 5 साल के कार्यकाल के बाद बड़े संतोष के साथ कह सकता हूं, और जो संतोष जनता जनार्दन ने ईवीएम के बटन को दबा करके भी व्यक्त किया है।
The Prime Minister added that he never thinks about polls in terms of victory and defeat, but as an opportunity to serve 130 crore Indians. He said that the NDA government is moving in the right direction without diversion or dilution. Let's listen into what more the Prime Minister said in his reply.
गरीबों का कल्याण हो, गरीबों का उत्थान हो, गरीबों का एम्पावरमेंट हो, लेकिन साथ साथ आधुनिक भारत को भी मजबूती से आगे बढ़ाना चाहिए। तो ऐसी पटरी पर विकास की धारा चलनी चाहिए जहां एक तरफ वेलफेयर को लेकर के ध्यान केंद्रित हो, सामान्य मानवीय की जिंदगी की आवश्यकताओं की पूर्ति पर भरपूर प्रयास हो, और दूसरी तरफ वो पटरी हो जो आधुनिक इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर का निर्माण करे। देश को आधुनिक बनाने के लिए योजनाओं को लागू करे, और हमने उन दोनों तरफ बल दिया, और हाईवेज हो या हाईवेज हो, वॉटरवेज हो, रेल हो या रोड हो, उड़ान योजना से हवाई जहाज की व्यवस्था हो, स्टार्टअप हो, इनोवेशन हो, टिंकरिंग लैब से लेकर के चंद्रयान तक की यात्रा की कल्पना हो, इन सारी चीजों को एक आधुनिक भारत और एक अनेक चुनौतियों से जड़ने के लिए हमें आगे बढ़ना। 25 जून की वो रात देश की आत्मा को कुचल दिया गया था। भारत में लोकतंत्र संविधान के पन्नों से पैदा नहीं हुआ है, भारत में लोकतंत्र सदियों से हमारी आत्मा है। इस आत्मा को कुचल दिया गया था। देश के मीडिया को दबोच दिया गया था। देश के महापुरुषों को जेल के सलाखों के पीछे बंद कर दिया गया था। पूरे हिंदुस्तान को जेल खाना बना दिया गया था। और सिर्फ किसी की सत्ता चली न जाए इसलिए, न्यायपालिका का जजमेंट था। न्यायपालिका का अनादर कैसे होता है उसका वो जीता जाता उदाहरण है। आज हमारे पास पूज्य बापू से बड़ी कोई प्रेरणा नहीं है। आज हमारे पास आजादी के लिए मर मिटने वाले वीरों से बड़ी कोई यादें नहीं है। यह अवसर खोना नहीं चाहिए। देश की आजादी के लिए जिन्होंने अपना जीवन खपा दिया, उनका पुण्य स्मरण करते हुए, जिन्होंने यातनाएं झेली, जिन्होंने अपनी जवानी मां भारती के लिए न्यौछावर कर दी, उनका पुण्य स्मरण करते हुए और देश में आजादी के लिए जन आंदोलन सफलतापूर्वक नेतृत्व करने वाले पूज्य बापू का स्मरण करते हुए, इन तारीखों का एक अवसर बना करके हम देश में फिर से एक बार स्पिरिट पैदा कर सकते हैं। और ये सरकार का एजेंडा नहीं हो सकता है, किसी दल का एजेंडा नहीं हो सकता है, ये पूरे देश का एजेंडा होता है। आजादी के पहले देश के लिए मरने का मिजाज था, आज आजादी 75 पर देश के लिए जीने का मिजाज पैदा करने का हमें अवसर मिला। बाबा साहब के आदेश हम सबके लिए उपयोगी है। वो कहते थे, मैन सफर्स मोर फ्रॉम लैक ऑफ वाटर देन फ्रॉम एक्सेस ऑफ इट। मैं समझता हूं कि बाबा साहब ने जो चिंता व्यक्त की थी, उस चिंता को समझते हुए हमने कुछ न कुछ सोचना पड़ेगा। और इसलिए इस बार हमने जल शक्ति मंत्रालय अलग से बनाया है। जल संकट को हमने गंभीरता से लेना होगा और इस सीजन में भी हम जितना बल जल संचय पर दें हमने देना चाहिए और मेरी सभी आदरणीय सांसद महोदयों से प्रार्थना है, सभी एनजीओ से प्रार्थना है कि हम देश में पानी का महात्म्य बढ़ाने में किस प्रकार से योगदान करें और सरकारी दायरे से बाहर होकर के करें। पानी बचाना है, इस काम को कर करके हम सामान्य मानवी की जिंदगी को बचाने में मदद कर सकते हैं और पानी का संकट दो लोगों को सबसे ज्यादा संकट पैदा करता है, वो गरीब को और विशेष करके हमारी माताओं बहनों को।
And Rajya Sabha resumed discussion on the motion of thanks to the President's address at 2 p.m. after condoling the demise of sitting member Madan Lal Saini. Members of various political parties took part in the debate during which they raised a host of issues. Let's listen in.
2014 से राष्ट्र निर्माण की जो नई सोच बनी, उल्लेख बड़ा स्पष्ट है, हम ये नहीं करें कि राष्ट्र निर्माण की सोच 2014 से बनी। हमने केवल विनम्रतापूर्वक ये कहा कि 2014 से राष्ट्र निर्माण की एक नई सोच बनी। राष्ट्र निर्माण की सोच पहले भी थी।
हमारी अर्थव्यवस्था चरमरा गई है। आप कहते हैं हम 2024 तक 5 ट्रिलियन आप यहां की इकोनॉमी पर ले आएंगे। 5 ट्रिलियन डॉलर इकोनॉमी में लाने के लिए आपको जीडीपी ग्रोथ होना चाहिए 20.11%।
But let's begin by giving some real numbers where we in opposition and those in government can work towards improving these numbers. Swast, 4 out of every 10 children in India are malnourished. Let's work to bring that number down to 3 and 2 together.
The entire speech, although has lot of things to say, has perhaps forgotten or missed the best part of economics or the economy. There is not a single word except for the reference about the economic reforms.
When we talk about electoral reforms, we concentrate only about what are the influences. We do not talk about the right of people to actually vote freely, fearlessly. And when that fear takes over an entire state, sir, it is something which is to be worried about.
राष्ट्रपति जी ने कहा, हर व्यक्ति को 2022 तक पानी, बिजली, सड़क की मूलभूत जरूरतों के साथ पक्का आवास उपलब्ध करा दे, किसानों की इनकम डबल करेंगे। बहुत अच्छी बात कही है और सरकार इस दिशा में काम भी कर रही है।
I am with all humility and respect to the Honorable Prime Minister asking him that how can the trust of Muslim minorities be won if there are recurrences frequently of mob lynching of Muslim youths.
जब पहली बार 2014 में वोट लिया था तब कहा था कि मेरी सरकार गरीब, शोषित, वंचित और पीड़ितों के प्रति समर्पित रहेगी और जो ही हमने किया था, जो हमने कहा था वो हमने किया, इसलिए जनता ने सबका साथ, सबका विकास और सबका विश्वास का मंत्र को समर्थन किया।
गवर्नमेंट इज स्पेंडिंग क्रोड्स एंड क्रोड्स ऑन स्वच्छ भारत मिशन बट नॉट एट ऑल कंसर्न अबाउट सफाई कर्मचारीज। स्टिल अराउंड 2 लाख विमन, आई टेक द नेम ऑफ विमन, Beti bacho, beti padho, all those things are there. But what about our women? 2 lakhs women are cleaning human excreta manually.
The state of Tamil Nadu, that is Honorable Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, Edappadi Palanisami's government, demanding 1,000 crore for eradicating trout in Tamil Nadu, sir, before Niti Aayog. I urge the government of India to release the 1,000 crore rupees immediately to eradicate trout in the state of Tamil Nadu, sir.
To prove the benefit of cooperatives in farming, the government seeks to set up 10,000 new farmer producer organization. It is a welcome step. Suggestion. But we further suggest that for strengthening of farmer producer organization and encouraging startup in agriculture to drought entrepreneurs should make agriculture an attractive proposition.
Everybody who is traveling in a train, do you expect them to know Hindi or English? How will they know? Even a farmer, a layman, a labor would be traveling by a train, and if the announcement is in Hindi or in English, what would he do? So on the persuasion of our leader, Mr. M.K. Stalin, our members of parliament met the general manager of the Southern Railways, and immediately they gave a circular. This is withdrawn with immediate effect. Why these unnecessary things?
This is an election which has seen the highest voter turnout ever in the history of independent India. And this is a huge mandate delivered to the NDA under the leadership of Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi. The ruling party, we have enhanced our vote share.
And the Election Commission on Tuesday fixed July 18th for elections to Tamil Nadu's 6 Rajya Sabha seats, which fall vacant next month. The poll panel said the notification for the election would be issued on July 1st, while voting would be held on 18th of July. The counting of votes will be undertaken the same day, soon after the voting. The terms of 6 Rajya Sabha members are to end on July 24th. The outgoing members include DMK leader Kanimuri, who was recently elected to the Lok Sabha. The 5 other outgoing members are D. Raja of CPI and AIADMK members R. Lakshmanan, K. R. Arjunan, V. Maitreyan and T. Rathinavel. On by-polls for 2 Rajya Sabha seats in Gujarat, the Supreme Court on Tuesday rejected the state Congress's plea challenging the Election Commission's decision to hold separate by-polls to the 2 seats. The Apex Court, however, granted liberty to the Gujarat Congress to file election petition after conclusion of polls to the 2 Rajya Sabha seats. An election petition is a procedure to call into question the election results of parliamentary, assembly or local elections. The plea was filed by Congress MLA and leader of opposition in Gujarat Assembly, Paresh Bhai Dhanani. By-polls to 2 Rajya Sabha seats are being held to fill the seats vacated by Union Ministers Amit Shah and Smriti Irani. BJP candidates for Gujarat Rajya Sabha seats, External Affairs Minister S. Jayashankar and OBC youth leader from Mehsana, Jugalji Thakur, filed their nominations on Tuesday. 2 ruling Biju Janata Dal candidates and 1 BJP nominee also filed their nomination papers for the by-election to the 3 vacant Rajya Sabha seats of Odisha on Monday. While BJD's Amar Patnaik and Susmit Patra filed their nomination papers for 2 Rajya Sabha seats in presence of party president and chief minister Naveen Patnaik in Bhubaneswar. BJP candidate Ashwini Vaishnav also submitted his papers with the returning officer. The 3 seats fell vacant after BJD's Achyuta Samanta, Pratap Kesri Dev and Soumyaranjan Patnaik resigned from Rajya Sabha after being elected to the Lok Sabha and State Assembly in the recently concluded general elections. Today is the last date for filing of the nominations for the by-polls and polling, if required, will be held on 5th of July. In its election manifesto, the BJP has promised to spend 100 lakh crore rupees on infrastructure to boost the economy and raise the living standards. After the impressive electoral victory, infrastructure creation and job growth will grab limelight in the upcoming budget to make India a $5 trillion economy by 2024. The interim budget allocated nearly 4.56 lakh crore rupees for the infrastructure sector for financial year 2019 and 20. The momentum created over the last 5 years indicates that the infrastructure sector is expected to get a major share in the upcoming budget. Urban mobility through the National Urban Mobility Mission could also be a focus area to promote the use of public transport and provide technology-based mobility solutions to local bodies. The use of electric vehicles in public transport is also expected to get a boost.
The hybrid annuity model, which was allowed in the infrastructure projects, should also be provided to the shipping and logistics sector. There should be logistic parks, dedicated freight corridors which are going to come up. There are going to be huge number of litigations. So there should be a need for a project management group at central level and at each state level.
Since the government has limited fiscal headroom, bringing private investment will be a topmost priority. Experts say 2019-20 budget may consider reintroduction of tax-free bonds to raise capital for infrastructure projects.
One of the unique or innovative ideas that we have been requesting the Honorable Prime Minister to consider remains a kind of investment allowance which had earlier been foregone. And at least in the infrastructure sector and also probably in the industry, it could be considered by her, and this could catalyze a new level of investments to come in.
Infrastructure development is critical for economic development. It has a domino effect on other sectors of economy as it helps improve productivity by removing infrastructural bottlenecks. Kriti Mishra, Rajya Sabha TV.
And some more developments, the Niti Aayog released its second round of health index on Tuesday. Kerala has occupied the top slot in terms of health performance among large states, followed by Andhra Pradesh and Maharashtra. Gujarat, Punjab and Himachal Pradesh stood at 4th, 5th and 6th spots respectively. While Uttar Pradesh, Bihar and Odisha were among the worst performing states on the index. In terms of annual incremental performance among the larger states, Haryana, Rajasthan and Jharkhand have been ranked the top three states. Among the smaller states, Mizoram ranked first in overall performance, while Tripura and Manipur were the top two states in terms of incremental performance. Sikkim and Arunachal Pradesh had the biggest decrease in overall health index scores. Among the union territories, Chandigarh ranked first in overall performance, while Dadra and Nagar Haveli improved the most.
Total 23 indicators pe hum log karte hain, jisme 10 outcome indicators hain. एक तीन गवर्नेंस और इंफॉर्मेशन रिलेटेड इंडिकेटर्स हैं और 10 जो हैं वो इनपुट्स और प्रोसेसेस रिलेटेड इंडिकेटर्स. सो टोटल 23 इंडिकेटर्स हैं और मेजर वेटेज जो है, अगर आप देखें वेट सेकंड कॉलम में, तो मेजर वेटर आउटकम को दिया गया है, प्रोसेसेस पे थोड़ा कम वेट दिया गया.
Swami Satyamitranand Giri Maharaj, a renowned seer, passed away in Dehradun on Tuesday after a prolonged illness. The 87-year-old head of Bharat Mata Janhit Trust was undergoing treatment for some time at the hospital. The Samadhi will be at Haridwar-based Raghav Kutir on Wednesday. Condolences poured in from a number of political and religious leaders who described his death as a big loss to the spiritual world. Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu and Prime Minister Narendra Modi condoled the demise of the spiritual leader, recalling his contribution in serving the tribals and the poor. In a tweet, Naidu said, and I quote, "Deeply saddened to know about the demise of Swami Satyamitranand Giriji Maharaj, who founded Bharat Mata Temple in Haridwar." Meanwhile, Prime Minister Narendra Modi in a tweet said that Swami Satyamitranand epitomized spirituality and wisdom. And some more developments, US Secretary of State Mike Pompeo and External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar will discuss a host of issues such as terrorism, H-1B visas, trade, and the situation arising out of U.S. sanctions on buying oil from Iran when they meet on Wednesday. This will be the first meeting between the two leaders after Jaishankar assumed office as External Affairs Minister last month.
U.S. Secretary of State Michael Pompeo will meet his Indian counterpart Subramaniam Jaishankar on Wednesday morning. Both leaders will lead delegation-level talks that will focus on trade, tariff, terrorism and people-to-people contacts, among other things.
Getting to know about India's concerns and India's position on some issues that have come up in the recent weeks and months. These include differences on trade, these include differences on the GSP program, they also include differences on things like Iranian oil imports, and also, you know, differences on India's plans to purchase the S-400 missile defense system.
The meeting will also finalize focus areas for discussions between Prime Minister Narendra Modi and US President Donald Trump on the sidelines of G20 summit in Osaka on 28th June. Other than this, both sides are expected to create convergence on cooperation on issues like Indo-Pacific, Huawei 5G, industrial security, patent issues, Iran, Afghanistan and China, among others.
Overall, the India-US relation remains very, very strong. But at the same time, there are some differences that have emerged. And this visit will give an opportunity to the two sides to, you know, lay out their positions on these issues on the table and hold some discussions before Prime Minister Modi meets US President Donald Trump on the sidelines of the G20 summit in Japan.
Pompeo will also meet Prime Minister Narendra Modi and will greet him personally on his re-election. Indian officials will also brief Pompeo about misconceptions on the tariffs from Indian side that are not excessive for a developing country. Pompeo will also address a business meeting in Delhi and deliver a lecture on India-US relations. Akhilesh Suman's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
Bank fraud fugitive Mehul Choksi's citizenship of Antigua may be revoked by the Caribbean country. He could be extradited to India after he has exhausted all legal options available with him. Choksi, currently based in the Caribbean nation of Antigua, told the High Court that he left India for medical treatment and not to avoid prosecution in the case. Choksi also said he would return to India as soon as he is medically fit to travel. And sports news now. After winning the FIH series title in Hiroshima in Japan, the Indian women's hockey team returned to India to a rousing welcome. The team had defeated host Japan to win the title. They were felicitated at the ceremony in New Delhi by Union Sports Minister Kiran Rijiju, who lauded them for their victory. India remained unbeaten through their campaign, scoring 29 goals and conceding just 4. The women's team recorded convincing victories over Chile, beating them 4-2 in the semi-final, and host and the Asian Games champions Japan 3-1 in the final.
जो अच्छा प्रदर्शन हमारा महिला हॉकी टीम ने किया है, हर एक प्लेयर ने बहुत अच्छा शानदार प्रदर्शन किया है, तो हमारे खेल मंत्रालय से इनको इंडिविजुअली और टीम के लिए जो कुछ चाहिए हम लोग बात करेंगे और जो भी संभव मदद है हम करेंगे. के जो कोचिंग ट्रेनिंग सेंटर है बेंगलोर में, तो मैं बेंगलोर भी जाऊंगा अगले महीने और मैन और वुमेन दोनों टीम के साथ उनके कोच के साथ बातचीत करके और ओलंपिक से पहले क्वालिफिकेशन के लिए और जो जो हो सकता है हम करेंगे.
कुछ हम लोग को सीखने को भी मिला है, काफ़ी कुछ हम लोगों ने इम्प्रूव भी किया है, तो जीत की तो खुशी सबको है ही है क्योंकि हमारे लिए जीतने टूर्नामेंट जीतना बहुत ज़रूरी था. क्यों हॉकी खेलना चाहिए क्योंकि अच्छी गेम है, सबको पता ही है हमारा नेशनल गेम है, तो जैसे अभी डे बाई डे हम लोग इम्प्रूव कर रहे हैं.
And that's all we have for you in this edition of News Tonight. Thank you for watching. Namaskar.